Hi people, I am here again. In one more paleobotany videos, paleobotany and paleonology for everybody. Today I will continue answer our question, how are plant fossils formed? And I will explain you about one process, named compression and impression. But before I give you the definition, I would like that you see this scenario. You see here, okay? I am in a backyard, and in this backyard there are many kinds of plants, and many things occur here. Plant die, leaves, flower, fruit, seeds, pollen, grains, fall, okay? And many things occur after it. For example, insects can come and eat it. Birds can come and eat it, or bacteria and fungi can decompose it, okay? But sediments can come and cover it also. If the sediment come, sediment will improve the temperature, will improve the pressure, and if it occurs during millions of years with chemical reactions, fossilization can occur, and a good fossils can be formed, okay? So everything that occurred in this backyard occurred millions of years ago. So suppose if I return to Carboniferous period between 359 and 299 million years ago. If I return there, okay, I would see the same things occur. Okay, same things. Because the chemical rules, the physical rules were the same, but with different kinds of plants, okay? Here in this backyard, there are many angiosperms. In Carbonífero, there were not angiosperms, okay? Only ferns and pteridosperms, okay? In Carbonífero, for example, was formed coal, seed coal. And how coal was formed? So in Carboniferous there were many swamp paleoenvironments, and many parts of the plants fell in this swamp paleoenvironment and were covered by sediments, and the temperature was improved. The pressure was improved, many chemical and physical reactions occurred, okay? So this mixed part of the plants were fossilized, okay? So here the coal is a mixed part of the plants, okay? Compressed by sediments, okay? This is during millions of years. During millions of years, people. Okay? So now I will show you another example. See this amazing example. Brachyphyllumbes. This is a leaf. I collect leaf. Sorry, this is a leaf. So I collected this fossil in Araripe Basin here in Brazil, in Ceará State. More specific in Santana Formation, in Crato Memba. The age of this fossil is more or less 120 million years ago. Okay? And if you see here a leaf, okay? And this leaf, okay, was deposited in a lacustrine paleoenvironment, okay? Lake. Okay, lake, in a lake, and the sediments covered this leaf, okay, sediment covered this leaf, improved the temperature, the pressure, okay, And some chemical components, for example, oxygen, nitrogen, and hydrogen, left this part, left, okay, left. And only carbon was kept. So now you see this membrane with the carbon. Okay, you see here this membrane with the carbon. Only it. This layer from layer with the carbon. You see it's brown layer, brown membrane with the carbon. Okay, only it here. So this is a very good example of this kind of fossilization, compression. Okay, very interesting. Okay, now I will show you another example. Okay, here is a leaf of gymnosperm. Now you see here. This is leaf outer, but of fern, okay, named Ruffordia. Some people say that it is anemiasia, and some people say that it is esquizácea, okay? But here you see the película, but not clear. And you see the part that is not the carbon, that is not the membrane. Okay? Why it? Because the water come here, okay? And carry out the carbon, carry out the membrane of carbon. Okay? So only the impression. So this is a good example of compression and impression. I will show you another example. You see here this amazing example, okay, collected in the same place, Araripe Basin. So the half of the fossil is with carbon, okay, with this membrane, with carbon. And another part not, without the carbon, so only impression. So here you can see clearly. Clearly, a compression and impression process. Okay? So, people, I hope you understand me. Sorry for my terrible English. So, you do your registration in this channel. And sorry for my terrible English. And bye.